Okay, back into Mass Effect. So, last time I played through, I fought my way into here and killed some Krogans. And we're going up to Peak 19 on Noveria, and we're going to see what's been going on up there. Please be ready for an attack. Let's see what's around here. Hold on one second. See. Why, my channel still looks like it's showing offline. So let me hold on. Go here. What's happening here? Okay, so that looks right. Dashboard's not looking right. Let's refresh the see. There we go. That's big. Okay, back into the game. Okay. End of it. Better in it. Okay. Need to be crouched down. Here's a bit. I am looking forward to. Oh shit. Come on. There we go. Okay, got a new pistol, a new sniper rifle, and some armor. Ooh. Let's take a look, see if any of this is any good. Yeah. I mean, I'm losing a bit of my tech biotic protection, but a little bit better, but look at those shields. Yes. Okay, it doesn't look that bad either. Let's take a look at the sniper rifle I just picked up. That's a pretty nice upgrade as well, too. Shots, better accuracy, a lot more damage. Yes. Okay. Now let's see, Liara, you are using that pistol. Okay, that's not that good. Garrus. I have to remember, for some strange reason, this quick save in here is F6. Almost every other great game uses F5. Okay. Mark. Rounds and proton. Pipe. Okay, you know what? That might be nice to put onto somebody. I'm gonna keep the incendiary rounds on here because I like lighting people on fire. But we can do a Garrus instead of the quiet rounds. Let's put these in there. Hold on. There we go. Stay alert. Be cold, be okay.
Why are the turrets facing the wrong way?
They want to keep their people in as much as they want to keep others out.
What are the charts there? Let's go see what's happening in security. Okay. Let us open you up. What's going on? I will admit, oh come on, I am not best at this minigame. Oh, really? Yes, I know, kind of cheeky, but. Why a quick save? So deal with it. New sniper rifle and new shotgun. Okay. I don't think the Naganata. Well, I could be wrong. I mean, a little bit of the accuracy difference there. Not enough to. I got a shotgun. You know what? I don't really carry a shotgun. You. So let's. Just in case. Don't tend to use the shotgun all that often. Four down rounds. Okay. They were looking at it. Like, there's no screens or anything on here. Yeah. Going into the cafeteria, it looks like. So quiet. Really? Let's put our guns away? Okay. So, how's it going? Did you watch X Show last night? Look, there's bad guys up ahead. No.
Take cover.
Oh crap. Okay. Hot Liara, you are so much in my way. I wonder why. Who is shooting at us? Who's left? I can't see anything. What? What? Okay. Cutscene. What is that? Rachni. Nice thing about this game is, oops. I don't have to worry about like ammo reloads. Just overheating. There's more of them. You know, when I've played this game before, I've always played like hiding behind cover a lot more than I am now. Okay. They are. You're not doing well. Personal logs. Administrator Tartakovsky. This is last time. No more will I use that transport carrier.
Three shipments we lose in Macedon system in 1 month. They are too stupid or too slow. If only Gregor still ran his shipments, he would get what I need and no mercenaries would dare to stop him. So they are under the floors. Nice, okay. Niara, you need to heal. It's not one, it's the other. And do I... Okay. Anything over here? Ban of saving. Make sure I'm not missing anything over here. Here's an elevator. Okay, map. What do I need to do? In the cafeteria. Okay. Seriously? Cafeteria is filled with snow? Why? You know what I need to do? I think it just makes better sense. Everybody's helmets on. Combat situations here, people. There we go. Your head needs to be protected. What was that? That was not a good sound. Ooh. Time's counting down. Okay. New pistol, another knocking on a sniper rifle. We'll use a pistol, let's see. Liara, I have a new pistol. I'm gonna give you the knocking on. Codec entry. Oh, that's what that sound was. Okay. I just know something's gonna burst out of the floor, isn't it? No. I'm, like, really tense right now. That was interesting. Negative contacts. I wish I was the one activating these doors opening. Okay, up the elevator. Let's put our guns away again. We have no idea what's happening, so we're just gonna put our guns away. Okay. Q, draw the guns, thank you. Guns are good when there are big scary insect creatures trying to kill you. Oh. Thank you, Liara. Perimeter secured.
A backup power system, Commander. It must be for the station's mainframe.
The damage is not extensive. It could be repaired.
Okay.
Critical startup error. Virtual intelligence user interface offline. Manual boot required.
Of course it does. Okay. Fusion reactor. Shield. Apparently they don't seem to like the cold. Yeah.
Doesn't it kind of look like GLaDOS, but... No. I'm just projecting. Okay. Take an elevator down into the computer core. It's probably warm down here. One thing to do. The VI core appears inoperational. You can attempt to manually reconfigure the databanks or use OmniGel to repair. Let's do... Oh, okay. Oh, it's this game. I like this game. Okay, memory one core transfer. Okay. So, view. View. View to you. View to you. View to you. Ooh, apparently it's not recognizing all my clicks. You to there, you to there, to there. Core reactivated.
It looks like you're trying to restore this facility. Would you like help?
Sure,
why
not?
You're the virtual intelligence that runs this place? This system is monitored to respond to the name Mira. May I ask your name?
I'm a Spectre.
Commander Shepard. I work for the Citadel's Special Tactics and Reconnaissance.
One moment, please. Council authority confirmed. You are entitled to secure access to all systems. Please note that queries relating to corporate secrets require privileged access. Privileged access is only available to Bunker Helix executives.
Okay, it was just a wee bit chilly. I wanted to turn on my heater.
You may access me at any holographic interface within Peak 15.
Okay. Where's Benezia?
I need to find Matriarch Benezia.
Lady Benezia departed on the passenger tramway to the Rift Station subsidiary labs. User alert. The tramway system is currently inoperable.
What's the situation here?
One moment, please. Diagnostics in progress. Critical failure. Main reactor shut down in accordance with emergency containment procedures. Manual restart required.
What were they containing?
Critical failure.
The Rack 9.
Connections are disabled. Passenger tram systems are offline. Report complete. Do you have an additional system status query?
So, Mass Effect's lore is kind of... Basically, the Mass Effect lore, the Rachni were a race of insect-like creatures. They fought in a giant war, the Rachni Wars. This is the war that the Turians, the one that Garrus is a member of, uplifted the Krogan to help fight. What happened was, is they uplifted the Krogan, gave them intelligence, took them off their planet, sent them throughout the galaxy. The Krogans did their fight, wiped out the Rachni. And then what happened was, now you have this, like, this army, this tool, that you no longer have a use for. And the problem is, the Krogans breed incredibly fast. So then they are now spread out through the galaxy. They're breeding like crazy, and they're a very militant, warlike race, who's basically, it's like, okay, we're going to go invade and take over. And so now you have the Turians having to deal with the Krogans, and the Council having to deal with the Krogans, and that's where the Genophage comes in, was that they limited the breeding of the Krogans. Let's see here. Let's find out about the main reactor.
Do you know why the reactor was shut down?
I'm sorry, but I was offline at the time. Shutdown could occur if reactor breach seems likely, or in the case of catastrophic laboratory containment failure.
Doesn't that sound great?
Emergency guidelines suggest the frigid environment will kill biological contagions. It may also damage mechanical ones.
Turn off the heat and hope the cold puts whatever you have unleashed to sleep. What do I need to do to get the power back on?
The valves to the helium-3 fuel line must be opened. This can be done at the controls on the reactor assembly proper.
What are the landlines and why are they disabled?
The landlines connect my mainframes here at Central Station to the various sub-facilities of Peak 15. This allows the crew to remotely access my databases from the comfort and security of their labs.
When emergency protocols were implemented within the hot labs, the cabling was automatically ejected.
How do I reconnect the landlines?
The landlines are designed for easy reconnection.
Sounds like a sale pitch.
For the landlines is on the roof of operations. Simply activate the controls and the hardware will reconnect and reboot automatically.
Tell me what happened here.
I'm sorry, but I need a more specific query.
The damage report. Let's find out what the final looks.
Immediately before you shut down.
Stage 1 alert issued at Hot Labs. Contaminants released from Laboratory Pod Gamma. Emergency protocols implemented. Stage 2 alert issued at Hot Labs. Isolation tube breached. Tram shut down. Landline to Hot Labs disconnected. Stage 3 alert issued locally. Contaminants in tram tunnels. Station shut down and evacuation initiated. Code Omega sent.
What sort of contaminants escaped?
I'm sorry, Commander. Inquiries related to our research require privileged access.
I'm a Spectre.
Only executives of Binary Helix have that level of clearance.
I have more clearance than all. Let's find out about the
hospital. Creatures we've encountered here, did they come from the labs?
I'm sorry, Commander. Inquiries related to our research.
Well, that answers that question, doesn't it?
Only executives of Binary Helix have that level of clearance.
Okay.
Why were you taken offline?
In the event, Peak 15 must be sterilized for security purposes. My program and data are purged.
They kill you if something goes wrong?
My systems are permanently disabled. To be killed, I would need to be alive. I am merely a database program.
Okay, I got everything.
That's all I need right now.
Very well, Commander. Logging you out. User alert. Main reactor shut down in accordance with emergency containment procedures. Manual restart required.
Okay, so, let's see.
User alert. Landline connections are disabled. Passenger trams are offline.
That's our roof access. Go to that first. I wish these things did not jump automatically.
Now exiting to the roof.
Thank you.
User alert. Landline connections are disabled. Passenger trams are offline.
Yes, yes, yes. Okay, what happens again?
User alert. Main reactor shut down in accordance with emergency containment procedures. Manual restart required.
It is cold up here. Okay, so now we got some more bugs.
User alert. Landline connections are disabled.
Hey man, I just healed you. Oh, there goes Liara. Yes, and we're all poisoned. I need more medjo.
Alert. Main reactor shut down in accordance with emergency containment procedures. Manual restart required.
Sucking up that med gel as if there were nothing.
User
to
alert.
It.
Landline connections are disabled. Passenger trams are offline.
Oh crap. There we go. Okay, another Striker, Raptor 4, Tsunami 4. Okay, let's see what we got. Okay, you're the same thing I'm using right now. You're not better. Garrus, you like a Tsunami. Do the Tsunami too. And... ooh. You can... yes. Make sure there's no chests. I mean, I know there's no other bad guys, but nope, let's get out of cover. Thank you. Okay.
are the landlines and why are they disabled?
The landlines connect my mainframes here at Central Station to the various sub-facilities of Peak 15. This allows the crew to remotely access my databases from the comfort and security of their labs. When emergency protocols were implemented within the hot labs, the cabling was automatically ejected.
How do I reconnect the landlines?
The landlines are designed for easy... The router for the landlines is on the roof of operations.
That's all I need right now.
Very well, Commander. Logging you out.
Where? Oh, wait, no, that's... Ah, there it is. Yay! Oh, God. I had two level ups, haven't I? Okay, wow, we're almost to the peak with assault rifles. More Spectre training, and oh, I can put my charm. But, oh, I still have more points. Let's peek out the soldier training, and let's do more assault. Yara. Okay. Sniper rifle's unlocked. That's good. I wish you would get up here to medium armor. Oh well. Why do you keep putting the guns away? They're in hostile territory.
User alert. Main reactor shut down in accordance with emergency containment procedures. Manual restart required.
Down. Yo. Yo, Garrus, how's it going?
Shut down in accordance with emergency containment procedures. Manual restart required.
Listen. Okay, let's go. Actors. Oh, that's right, because you regenerate. Game and its elevators.
Main reactor. User alert. Main reactor shut down in accordance with emergency containment procedures. Manual restart required.
Okay. Hey, bad guy.
User alert. Main reactor shut down in accordance with emergency
and
containment
we have Keth.
Procedures. Manual restart required.
Good. It's with all the cold stuff. Okay. I can go either way. This way.
Required.
Are we dealing with both Rachni and Geth here?
Thank you.
Officer alert. Main reactor shut down in accordance with emergency containment procedures. Manual restart required.
The HE3 fuel line's out.
What was that? There's still another bag. Oh, there we go. Okay.
Oh. User alert. Main reactor shut down.
Back to full.
In accordance with emergency containment procedures.
Hello, everybody. Manual restart required. Okay. It's really weird. Every time else that I've played this game, I've always, like, hidden behind cover for so much of the game, and I mean, here I'm just like out, just blasting at things. I don't know whether it's a change from having played more games like Overwatch and Battlefield, and I don't know. It's supposed to be kind of not only a cover shooter, but at the same time, let's wait up there. Let's go. What's up there? I mean, I have pretty good shields, and I'm using the assault rifle. I don't know. I'm just playing completely differently than I've ever played this game before. I mean, combat-wise, which is actually not my favorite part of this game. Okay, lots of support. Right. Just send some of the stuff that I have down on the shelf. Oop. Lots of stuff. Bean, exoskeleton, kinetic stabilizer. Up here. Recoil dampener. This. Oh, hello. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, we'll keep incendiary rounds. I like lighting things on fire. But this is first aid interface, which is killing me. That's that. Plus 10% damage. Okay. Oh. Hello, medical interface. 4. 5, okay. So you're gonna fell all the way down here. Fell. So I get a bunch more on. We'll keep the striker, because the striker's not bad. Or pistol one. Let's get rid of all the things. Wait, I don't want omni gel. Up to 100 omni gel. The rest we'll sell because we actually need money to buy things. Yeah, this is where a shot was up here. Okay. Oh. This is why you go and keep poking around into the corners because you find things like this. There we go. Tornado 4, Hunter 4, Equalizer 4. Any good? Equalizer. Ooh, hello. Yes. Not so good. Yeah. Save and it jumps. There we go. Let's go back up here. Okay, I think I got everything I need here. Now we can go take the trams. And
we get to go see what else is going on. And we get the really fun battle against the Asari Commandos coming up, which I will probably die at. I've been actually thinking it might be fun with all the games that I play that I die at and die a lot at, and such, actually putting a death counter onto my stream here. I might still do that. Put a overlay with kind of a death counter that I can increment every time I die in a session. We'll put the guns away. Go down. Put the guns because we're going to go here and there's going to be another Rachni to kill. Because there always is. Save. Yep. Darn, I got poisoned again. I got poisoned, but I heal. That's the last of them. Okay. The trams. Another elevator. For Mass Effect, I should also put it.
Decontamination and transit hub.
Okay, I should also put an elevator counter on here.
Loose contaminants in the decontamination chamber. Access to passenger tramways inadvisable.
Draw a gun, please. Thank you. Okay, Liara. Okay, you're gonna get poisoned again right after this here, but. Oh, wait. Seriously?
Connections restored. Processing new data. User alert. Unable to connect to hot lab facilities.
What's this about loose contaminants?
Dangerous biological agents are
present. Yeah, the guy right over there.
Decontamination chamber. The tram station has been sealed in the interest of crew safety. Activation of the fail-safe plasma jets is recommended.
Except I can't do it.
How do I activate the failsafe system?
Controls for the failsafe systems are located in the security checkpoint outside decontamination. User alert. The failsafe system is currently inoperable.
What would it take to get the decon failsafes operating again?
There is a hardware fault in the control system. This can be repaired on-site using a standard Omni tool.
Unlock the decontamination chamber.
User alert. Contaminants are present within the decontamination chambers. Passage is not recommended.
How do I get rid of the contaminants?
The chamber. Unfortunately, the fail-safe system is disabled.
I don't have time for this. Override.
Very well, Commander. Releasing safeties. Proceed at your discretion.
That's all I need right now.
Very well, Commander. Logging you out.
We are just gone.
Can't escape. Up the tunnels now. We're sorry. The leads couldn't get to the truck. Get out while you can.
Not now, Shepard.
Oh, another medical interface. Ooh, you know who we can put this on? Because she keeps getting poisoned. Yara. There we go. Yeah, Terminator 4. I think the Terminator was like. No, it isn't. But let's see. Can't. Oh, better cooldown bonus. There we go. Okay. Quick save. Oh, because there's bad guys on the screen. Ready? Oh, where did you come from? Where
Where did you come from? God, you're an ugly bastard, aren't you? Yes, we're just gonna kind of wait till we... Actually, no, go on. I think we're all clear.
All clear.
Thank you, Liar. At some point, you're gonna not be poisoned anymore. I know I could be using my tactics better. I know I could be using my teammates better, but I have an assault rifle that burns people alive. And I have shields. This is fine. So tense. I never know when somebody's gonna jump out and just like wanna bite me. Hey. Hey, who's driving this thing? Yes, I am. You guys on? Save. Nope, failed, because I'm on a moving vehicle.
Departing Central Station. Destination, Rift Station.
Okay. Here we go. So this is like the elevator that moves sideways. I don't know if I would count that as an elevator, though, because it doesn't elevate.
Arriving at Rift Station, Binary Helix Research Facility.
And we are going to have more things to shoot. So we're ready to shoot. I also spend a lot of my past games in sniper rifle mode. Here it's all about the assault rifle. Okay, where do I need to go? Elevator's not. Oops. Oh, hold on. Oh, this place is big. Big. Okay, they're in a restricted area. Here's the lab. Why do you keep doing that to me? Okay. To the hot lab science station. I want to check those out or do I want to... Okay, oh, I can't. Emergency exit only. So I guess that means I have to go over the green door. Look at me. Garrus, get out of my way. Well. Can't be door A. Therefore, we have to go into door B. Into elevator B. Another elevator. Ding. And we put the guns away. Because apparently it's unsafe to have guns on an elevator. Okay.
Be sure what was on the tram.
Can those things work a train's controls?
Hell if I know. I'm not assuming any goddamn thing. Look,
they're a set of space-faring insects. I think they can probably handle a train.
My name's Shepard. I'm a Spectre.
Huh. I won't look a heavily armed horse in the mouth. The aliens overran the hot labs last week. Only Han Olar got out, and he ain't all there anymore. First, we knew the bastards were clawing into my command post. We had a lot more staff then.
You were taken by surprise and had civilians to protect. You did a good job, Captain.
Yeah? Sure as hell doesn't feel like it. The board sent an Asari to clean up the mess. She went to the hot labs yesterday. We haven't heard from her since.
Benicia.
I'm not gonna let any of your people die.
All I can do is hold out here and protect the civilians.
There's an emergency elevator out by the trams. This card will let you activate it. It can take you down to the hot labs.
Oh, and if you need any first aid, Dr. Cohen's downstairs in the med bay.
Okay. Let's start with the facility.
Tell me about Rift Station.
I can't talk about everything. What you need to know.
Oh, let's see.
Tell me about the defenses here.
Secure enough that you shouldn't poke in corners.
I was just impressed with your operation. Being able to weather a week of assaults is no mean feat.
Only the best get assigned to high security facilities like this. What impresses me most is the turrets, alarms, and cameras. They're all routed through a central location out by the quarantine labs. One guy can lock down the whole facility. The security hub's the last logical fallback, and we'd have cover from the turrets all the way.
What kind of research is done here?
Beats me. I'm not supposed to know. So long as people don't start dying, it's not my problem.
But people started dying. Therefore, it became your problem.
What can you tell me about the aliens?
Ask Dr. Olar. He's the only one who made it out of the hot labs. He's the only Volus left in here.
Hot labs.
I need to know more about the situation in the hot labs.
The facility's off the network. The only way to find out would be to send scouts down the elevator, and I won't send my people to their death.
Did the aliens come from inside the facility, or did they attack from the outside?
You want my personal opinion? Labs like that exist to do stupid crap that gets people killed.
He has a good point there.
Tell me about the structure of the hot labs.
It's built into one of the glaciers further down the mountain. Real old, thick, stable one. Something goes wrong, they heat it up and sink it into the ice. Normally, the crew gets to the labs using a tram from Central Station. We've got an elevator that connects directly, but it's for emergency use only.
Listen, I'm not sending my people down there. It's too dangerous. You understand?
You have told me that a couple times already.
How are your people holding up?
We weren't expecting the
I got chocolate for them.
They made it inside. We lost some good people. Those of us left are shorthanded. We've kept order by long shifts and stems. I don't like it, but I don't see an alternative.
You're certain the Matriarch is still in the hot labs?
She hasn't come back here. You came through Central Station, so she ain't there.
Okay, I've got all the information I need from you.
I hear that.
Oh.
Hell! Man the perimeter!
Look out!
Where are
go,
we going?
Go, go!
Oh. Rush at me and I punch you.
I think we're good, Shepard.
You're not doing so well.
Thanks for the help. Every few hours, a group comes up the tram tunnel. It's actually better since we locked down the elevator.
I'll do whatever I can.
I don't know why they keep throwing themselves against our defenses. Even animals should learn not to stick their noses where it hurts.
Okay. Dude, you're actually not going to talk to me? Okay, can't shoot you. Okay. Garrus. Heal up. Okay, so. Here. Why is that? Quarantine lab. Medical bay. Let's go talk to the medical bay. I think I should be okay. Gun, all throwing.
I do not like this place. Too many dark secrets.
What is the point of this room? Why is this even labeled on the map? There's a med bay. I can stop my middle. Yeah, I just might.
Where did they come from? Were they in the lab? I never went in the high security areas.
Sick.
You seem less upset about this situation than the others.
That is one of the virtues of the meditation you interrupted.
Okay.
You're a member of the science teams.
Recently transferred, yes.
What do you study?
What do you do here?
Molecular genetics. I specialize in biotic enhanced allele specific hybridization.
Yeah, that's a bit technical for me.
I am very good at tracking inherited variations.
She's talking slowly.
I'm sure you would find it quite dull.
Maybe.
Tell me about yourself.
I am a
lesbian. Why am I asking this?
University of Arrhaeus. Is there anything in particular you want to know, or should I just spout random facts?
Like to go on a date? Maybe? Who knows?
Did I interrupt something?
I was meditating. I suppose to a species as brash as yours, it would appear to be inattention.
Do you know Matriarch Benezia?
Why ask me and not your friend?
Because I do not know anything about the Matriarch.
Then why would I?
You're lying, Liara.
That's all for now.
Why did Liara lie about that?
I will return to my meditations.
The sooner we leave this frozen world, the better.
Why did she lie about that? Sorry, I don't smoke. Yay.
What? No. Sorry, I haven't had much sleep since the attack. Is there something you need?
Okay, we have lots of information here. Let's ask about this lab.
What sort of work do you do here?
I can't say. I signed a non-disclosure agreement. If we survive, I'd like to keep my job.
Yeah, that's not happening, dude.
But the pay is better than any other commercial lab.
You're not happy on Peak 15?
Oh, it's 15, not 19. I thought it was Peak 19.
It doesn't exist here, just walls of ice.
Sorry about my post earlier.
The discovery. It's easy to forget why science is guided by ethics. Maybe we're paying for that now.
Yeah.
What do you know about the hot labs?
Nothing, I didn't work there. As far as I know, Han Olar was the only survivor.
Can I find him?
Medical ward?
No, he's staying in the science team's quarters. Be gentle with him. He had a trying experience.
Let's get personal with him.
I'm a toxicologist. I can't talk about my work. Not that I'm doing anything since the accident.
There was an accident here?
I can't talk about what happened. Not here. Too public. Talk to Dr. Cohen in the medical ward. He was the project lead.
How are you holding up?
It would be petty to complain after showering off a coworker's brain. None of us have had
an
emergency attack. Of course, not all of us have guns.
I do. I have lots of guns.
I'm looking for an Asari.
Asari? Well, there's Dr. Ialis over there.
Yeah, she's a bitch.
There's also our guest, Lady Benezia. Captain Ventralis might know where she is.
I'll talk to you later.
Remember to report any suspicious noises.
Okay, yes, if there's any suspicious noises, I probably will shoot them. Because that is Shepard's kind of modus operandi.
Uncertain. I welcome you. Cautiously, I am curious to know what you're doing here.
I heard there were some problems up here.
Furtively. I am concerned about the state of our guards. Many have been out for days.
You're talking about the hunting.
With forced cheer. I still have a limited supply of equipment to sell.
That's a sell crap. Just give me what you have.
This doesn't seem like the time for commerce.
Oh, capitalism thrives everywhere. Every time.
I have nothing else to do.
I'm bored. I'm just gonna sell stuff.
Kiosk.
Let's have a look.
Regretfully, most of my stock is being appropriated by Captain Ventralis.
And that's 70. Why 42,000? Wow, okay. It's heavy armor, human. Pink. What is it with the pink armor? Actually, I already have better armor. Sorry, is it watering? Why would I spend 76,000 for pink armor? It's not as good. It's better on the tech biotic protection, but everything else is not. You also said, no, your 50s are, I still can't afford you. Anything I can afford. Ooh. Ooh, wait. Power bonus. think I want to keep it. That'd be nice if I could get him to wear it, travel with him. So, dude, you don't have anything. Let's sell some stuff. Okay. Get rid of you. Sell you. Get rid of all the two stuff. Fours now. You hold out of that. You know, I think I'm gonna sell the ship. And so I'm gonna, because we wanna incorporate people. Okay, so guard barracks. Let's go check in there. Which I think these people are. Or let's just steal their stuff. I know I'm playing Paragon, but this is what you do in games like this. Is you go into places, break into places, and steal the shit. Took all their weapons. And taking all their weapons. Yeah. Such a Paragon thing to do. Let's see. Going to the quarantine lab. Going downstairs. Secure. Oh god. To secure. Downstairs. Down, down, down.
I know you'd have a cure by now.
You're not talking. That's not a good sign.
What do you want?
I didn't mean to bother you.
No, you did nothing wrong. I'm just distracted.
What happened to these people?
They're suffering from a toxin. There was an accident. I have a non-disclosure agreement. I shouldn't discuss it with anyone outside of the company.
I think I know what's happened.
But you're going to, because I might be able to help.
And I'd like to think that the company finds our lives more valuable than their secrets. You know Mira, the VI for Peak 15? She handles the safety protocols for our experiments here.
We reactivated her on our way through Central Station.
That was you? I'm grateful. Until she came online, the automatic equipment wouldn't work. We lost the connection to Mira in the middle of an experiment and the quarantine failed. These three were exposed to a toxin, something we were working on.
It's suspicious.
I understand your caution, but I need details. What you say won't go beyond these walls.
It's a bioweapon, based on an exotic life form discovered on the frontier. They wanted something that could kill the creature, but there was no profit in something that kills one species on the frontier. We kept working on it and adapted it to affect more species. Thoros B is highly infectious, but can't pass from one person to another, like a biowar attack without a pandemic spread.
It doesn't matter how safe you make it. Biological weapons are illegal.
Yeah, biological weapons are scary things.
They'll get this kind of weapon one way or another, and we're trying to limit the damage. I know you can't see that.
There's a reason the Citadel Conventions forbid bioweapons, Doctor.
I didn't expect you'd understand. Our notes and equipment are locked in the quarantine labs. Captain Ventralis doesn't want to risk more contamination.
Is he right to keep people out?
No, the toxin has a brief period of viability. After that, it breaks down into simple protein chains. But he won't listen to me.
I'll talk to him. Maybe I can convince him to let me try.
Then I can destroy them.
I'm not going to do this officially, but if you can do anything, I'd appreciate it.
What will it take to get the cure for these people?
The quarantine labs are near the science team's quarters. Once you're in there, look for our notes. It should just be a matter of following our processes.
How's the science team holding up?
Better than Ventralis' guards. They've been on alert since the first attack. I'd been administering stims at their request. But every species needs to sleep. They're getting twitchy, irrational.
Are you the doctor?
I'm a doctor, but not the doctor. My specialty is microbiology, not first aid. Dr. Salah, but he's
dead.
Lost him. The automatics can handle basic treatment. Mira runs them.
Talk to you later.
I hope you can do something.
Yeah, I can, screw up their entire research project. Because it's not good. Okay. Security. Assault drones. Can the assault drone?
Warning. Watchdog protocol is active.
What is... Okay, there are... I should probably have saved before I did this. What just happened? Why are you guys shooting at me? Really? I am so confused at what's going on right now. Are you? Why? There we go. I don't even know why I'm shooting at these people now. Where are you shooting? Who are you shooting at? I'm so confused. Why all of a sudden... Where am I going? Your lab. Why? Quarantine lab. Good jobs. What's going on? Okay. I didn't mean to do this. I don't know where that's going up there, so we're gonna go back this way. Okay. Is this guy gonna kill me too? Yes, you are. I'm gonna kill all the guards. Ooh, I overheated. I am so confused at what's going on right now. Why are people... Everybody here is dead. You're not dead. Kind of feel like I should like reload and go. I think I might do that. Is that way back there? I should have. Oh wow! Let's go back. Yes. So I didn't want this to happen. To kill some more Rachna. We are okay. We're back here. We have to go do this whole discussion. Okay. When did I last save? Really? I saved all the way back here? Oh, come on. Okay. Sorry about this. I should probably have just kept playing. Nothing to it now. Okay. Fine. Did it autosave here? Self, don't go break it in. There wasn't even anything worth breaking into there for at that point, unless I wanted to go up to those labs. Now everybody was going to try to kill me too, so. Okay. Can't go that way. Let's go this way. Says. Okay. Let's go. You know what? Save. And we're just gonna save more often again. So what's the thing? This time I turned around instead of facing them. Like back to the door that's gonna open up and enemies are gonna kill me. The Shepherd is such a great security expert.
If you need any first aid, Dr. Cohen's downstairs in the med bay.
Tell me about Rick. Tell me about the defenses here.
Secure enough that you shouldn't poke in corners.
I was just impressed with your operation.
Only the best get assigned. What impresses me most, one guy can lock down the whole facility. The security helps the last logical.
What kind of research is
done? Beats me. I'm not supposed to know. So long as people don't start.
Tell me about the defenses.
Designed to survive a breach. The turrets and alarms.
Tell me about Rick.
I can't talk.
Tell me about the defenses.
Oh, come on.
It's designed to survive a breach.
Okay,
can you tell me about
the Dr. Olar. He's the only one who made it out of the hot lab.
I need to know more
the
about
facilities off the network. The only way to find out would be to send
scouts. Did the aliens
down here.
Come from inside?
You want my personal opinion?
Labs like that exist to do stupid crap.
Tell me about the structure of the
hut. It's built into one of the glaciers. Normally the crew gets to the labs using...
Listen. I'm not sending my people down there. It's
how are your people holding up?
Those of us left are shorthanded. We've kept order by law.
You're certain the matriarch...
She hasn't come back here. You came through Central Station, so she ain't there.
I've got work to do.
Yeah, I hear that. Hell! Man the perimeter!
Go, go, go! Go, go, go!
That's it. Bag of attack.
Thanks for the help.
I'll do whatever I can.
I don't know why they keep doing it.
Okay. Okay. Let's go do all this again. Garrus. There we are. I'm fine. Okay. Okay. What do you think we're gonna do? We're gonna go steal their shit again. Come on, really? There we go. I took all that stuff. Okay, that's...
Where did they come?
You go to the hot labs, are you?
What?
You're a member recently transferred.
Yes. What do you do here?
Molecular genetics. I specialize in biotic...
Yeah, that's a bit technical.
I am very good at tracking... That is one of the virtues of the meditation.
Tell me about yourself.
I am Molestia Ialis from the University.
Did I interrupt something?
I was meditating. I supposed to a species express.
Do you know matriarch?
Because I do not know anything about
then why would I?
That's all for now.
Then I will.
Yeah. The last game.
What? Sorry.
What sort of work
I can't. Is terrible, but the pay is better.
You're not happy on peak food?
It's easy to forget why science is guided by ethics.
What do you know about the hot
Nothing,
lab?
I didn't work there. As far as I know, Hanuman...
Is he in the medical world?
No, he's still... Be gentle with him. He had a trying experience.
What do you do here?
I'm a toxicologist. I can't talk about my work.
There was an accident?
I can't talk to Dr. Cohen in the medical ward. He was the project lead. None of us have had enough sleep since the attack.
I'm looking for an
assignment. There's also our guest, Lady Benezia. Captain Ventralis, my
I'll
associate.
Talk to you later.
Remember to report any suspicion.
Let's see. Down. Go pick up stuff here, put the notes.
Hang on. What do you want?
I didn't mean to bother.
You did not.
What happened?
I have a non-disclosure agreement. Shouldn't have
you going?
I'd like to. You know Mira, the VI for peak.
We reactivated.
We look, these three were exposed to a toxin.
I understand your
but the Forest B.
It doesn't matter how
safe. Governments. They'll get this kind of weapon one way or another.
There's a reason the city.
I know it's an equipment. I locked in the quarantine.
Is he right to keep people?
No, the toxin has a brief period of fire.
I'll talk to him.
I can't ask you to do this.
Talk to you later.
I hope you can do something.
Okay. Active in trial, entered quarantine lab. Okay. And we'll save. Now I don't have to redo all this bit again. Let's go talk to Ventralis. Or Captain Ventralis. Should use his actual title. Yeah, you don't have anything for me worth. Oh no, wait, you did. No, you didn't. We'll talk to Ventrella. Oh, Wait, just in time for another attack?
Something you need?
I've heard about the problems in the quarantine lab. I'd like to recover the toxin cure.
God, I wish we could help those guys. I really do, but we can't risk contamination now.
We're not part of your defense plans. We're consuming extra rations, extra metagel.
Yeah, but you also have extra guns. All right, you want to gamble with your life, you're not under my command. I'll have the guard let you in, but he'll lock the door behind you. He'll run a full scan before he'll let you out. If there are any anomalies, you stay in there.
Those are reasonable precautions.
I'll radio ahead to let the guard know. Good luck.
I've got work to do.
You and me both.
Last time I said that, we were attacked. Okay. Where is barracks? The quarantine lab. There I can't get through.
Something you need?
I've got work to do.
You and me both.
Downstairs is. Another elevator. Ding. Metagel. Goes with that.
You came to find out about them, didn't you?
You mean those things out there?
Yes. I'm the only survivor from the hot lab, you know.
I need to know more about those things out there.
About the Rachni?
Rachni?
That's preposterous.
Though, unfortunately, the game kind of spoiled that reveal by telling us the name of the aliens when we were attacking them and putting that up in like the little heads-up display. It could have just kept it as aliens, but no, it was telling us they were Rachni. I mean, granted, I knew that, I've played this game before, but well, it's kind of a spoiler they gave us.
Where did they come from?
They found it in a derelict ship, an egg, waiting since the last battles. They brought it here.
Shut up! God, you want to get us killed?
I don't have any control over who lives or dies here. Do you?
If you're gonna be crazy, be the quiet kind.
Crazy? I'm sane. God, am I sane.
I need to know everything about the Rachni.
I told you all I can. We brought the Rachni back from the dead. In retrospect, a bad decision.
I heard you were at the hot labs. How did you make it out alive?
I killed her.
Who?
Dr. Zonmua. We were going to lunch when the alarms went off. I ran into the tram and I closed the doors. She banged on the window once, then they sliced her to pieces. Her head came apart like a melon. I closed the door. I killed her.
Tell me what you know. I'll make your survival mean something.
You think I want absolution?
He feels guilty about that.
Could Matriarch Venezia survive in the hot labs?
It's possible. The specimens were sensitive to biotics.
I'll be leaving now.
I'll leave you with your guilt.
Gotta keep the mood light. I mean, if you don't laugh, you'll... Yeah, you just have to. I used to have nightmares like this.
Dudes, you're the ones with the crazy... Go down here, and let's take care of this. We go in and die of suffocation.
You're not part of the crew.
I have Ventralis' permission.
Yeah, you radio. He also said you have to prove you're not contaminated to get out. You got a death wish? You should stay and watch us on the barricade.
Yeah. I've already killed. I've killed probably more than you have. Hold. Oh. Okay. Save and let's loot the place. Boy. Oh, in this one. This one I can do. Maybe. Yep. Medium armor. Horror. You can probably wear medium armor. Aura. No, you can't. The A-Light armor. Okay. Into here. Hit. Take that. Full metagel. And there is nothing in here. Okay. Save again. Oh.
Your mission ends here, Shepard.
Ambush.
What happened to Ventralis's man?
I didn't have permission to come in. He got in my way. I was ordered to eliminate you should the opportunity arise. And here you are, trapped in this lab. Weapons free! Enemy contact.
Where are you? And, okay, I am in a... Sorry, Garrus, for shooting you in the back.
All clear.
Yeah, I'm definitely not using cover the way I used to. Okay, what did I pick up? Anything good? Granada 4. I don't think that's that good. Okay, did I do my cure? Aha. Well, at least I don't have to worry about the guard not letting me out. Oh, dude. So, I like how she was able to kill him, and these guys are just standing here calmly, just like they were before. Because that makes so much sense.
They came out of there.
You mean the inorganics the Asari had with her?
Venezia brought them with her.
How can I get into the maintenance area?
A team lead would have access. Like Dr. Cohen. He's in the medical bay.
I'll be leaving now.
Ah, okay. I'm actually trying to go. Okay, oh, there. I see where I'm at. Let's do some more stuff. Is there more stuff to take? Okay. Back to the elevator. Okay. So she also liked Liara light up Epinesia. And Alara, or whatever her name was, she lied about Venezia. Everybody lies about Venezia. At least Liara didn't lie to me. Okay. Around and around. I need to.
Is that the cure? You did it?
That Asari scientist, the one in the mess hall? She just tried to kill us.
Alestia? That's unbelievable. I don't know much about her. She arrived a month ago. One of the shareholders pulled strings to get her here.
Let me guess. Saren the Spectre.
Yes. I think that was the name. I don't pay attention to the research teams. The guards? They've been more on edge since you got here. I think they were expecting you. And there are more left back. The guards won't even let me back there. Just people with clearance.
What about the maintenance area? Do you have access to that?
The maintenance area? Yes. Take my pass. But there's just snow back there. Let me see that file. An extension on Philip's work? I thought he was on the right track. I can't thank you enough that... Oh, God, what a cliche. You saved their lives. Do you know that?
Could you spare a few medical packs? They're worth their weight in gold up here.
You didn't get these...
I don't need any more.
And Trollis wanted them saved for his people. Need to administer this. Thanks again.
Yeah, Metagel Zero. Okay. Quarantine. Door. Okay. Ah, so now I don't have to go kill all the guards. I get it. Okay, everybody's healed. Put you away. Save. I see, so now I don't have to kill those guards. Fight through that way. I can go the other way. Dude. You get to live. And dude. Do you really want to use it against me? Okay, here we go. Back into the elevator. Ding. Again, hey, they pass. Door's open. Wait, so now the door. Snow. Aura. Aura. Thank you. Thank you. Because I am a badass. Journal. Okay. breaking in, you've entered the unguarded back door into the sealed. Guards are not alerted to your presence. Yay! So I don't have to kill innocents. Let's see if I can get this one. You know what, maybe... Yes! Okay. At some point I should just omni-chill because I'm just getting repeated. Okay. Able to save. Good. Okay, where am I? I am here. Okay. Guess I am going... That is... Okay. Secure labs. Yes, here we are. I remember this. Wait, was a pain in the butt.
You do not know the privilege of being a mother. There is power in creation. To shape a life, turn it toward happiness or despair. Her children were to be ours, raised to hunt and slay Saren's enemies. I won't be moved by sympathy, no matter who you bring into this confrontation.
Liara's here because she wants to be, not because I asked her to.
Indeed. What have you told her about me, Liara?
What could I say, Mother? That you're insane? Evil? Should I explain how to kill you? What could I say?
Have you faced an Asari commando unit before? Few humans have.
Can't believe you'd kill your own daughter.
I now realize I should have been strict with her.
Okay. I think I have better weapons, at least. I'm frozen. I can't move. I'm in stasis. Okay, cover would be nice. Ah! Nice his power level. Okay. Oh, now we've got the Eth. Just marvelous. Oh, there they are. Yara, get out of my way. Why aren't I shooting? There we go. Yes, die. Okay. Me, but I am kind of brutal. Oh god, okay, come on. Oh, dear god. Is there somebody behind me? There is. Seriously? I'm in stasis again. Wonderful. That's right, I need to kill that other one. Or I can... Ow, who the hell is shooting at me? Where?
This is not over. Saren is unstoppable.
My mind is filled
with not his light.
Everything is clear. The Rachni didn't cooperate with you. Why should I? I will not betray you. You will. You must listen. Saren still whispers in my mind. I can fight his compulsions.
Indoctrination.
But the indoctrination is strong. Why are you able to break free of his control now? I sealed a part of my mind away from the indoctrination, saving it for a moment when I could help destroy him. It will not last long.
So you could turn on me again?
Yes, but it would not be my will, Shepard. People are not themselves around Saren. You come to idolize him, worship him. You would do anything for him. The key is Sovereign, his flagship. It is a dreadnought of incredible size.
And it's not a ship.
The power is extraordinary.
Sovereign's not like other ships. Where did it come from?
I cannot say. The Geth did not build it. Its technology is far more advanced than that of any known species. The longer you stay aboard, the more Saren's will seems correct. You sit at his feet and smile as his words pour into
Sounds like a cult.
It is subtle at first. I thought I was strong enough to resist. Instead, I became a willing tool, eager to serve. He sent me here to find the location of the Mu Relay. Its position was lost thousands of years ago.
How does something that big go missing?
4,000 years ago, a star nearby went supernova. The shockwave propelled the relay out of its system, but did not damage it. It's precise.
Not the time for exposition.
To determine. As millennia passed, the nebula created by the nova enveloped the relay. It is difficult to find any cold object in interstellar space, particularly something swathed in hot dust and radiation.
Someone on Noveria found it?
2,000 years ago, the Rachni inhabited that region of our galaxy. They discovered the relay. The Rachni can share memories across generations. Queens inherit the knowledge of their mothers. I took the location.
I love the Rachni and the Rachni lore. Another great thing that BioWare does actually is just the development of their lore in this game. Okay, so she's fighting off Saren's indoctrination, yet I'm still able to ask questions.
How did the Rachni find it? They searched patiently. They are territorial creatures driven to close any possible way into their systems.
Why does Saren need the new relay?
He believes it will lead him to the conduit. I would tell you more if I could, but Saren did not share his counsel with me. I was merely a servant to his cause.
You can still make it right. Give me the information.
I was not myself, but I should have been stronger. I transcribed the data to an OSD. Take it, please.
Knowing the relay's coordinates is not enough. Do you know where he planned to go from there?
Saren wouldn't tell me his destination. But you must find out quickly. I transmitted the coordinates to him before you arrived. You have to stop me. I can't. His teeth are at my ear. Fingers on my spine. You should. Oh, you should.
Mother, I... Don't leave! Fight him!
You've always made me proud, Leon.
Aww. Die! Wow, that was... Oh, there's another bad guy. It would be nice to, Okay, so you guys are dealing with that. I'm gonna go deal with this guy over here. Yes, you're dead. And now so are you.
I cannot go on. You will have to stop him, Shepard. Hold on. We've got Metagel. Maybe we can... No. He is still in my mind. I am not entirely myself.
That's a weird headdress.
Mother.
Well...
always said there would be a
okay. Now comes the first instance. If you play the Renegade path in this game, it gets dark, especially when you do the loyalty missions in Mass Effect 2. Here's the first instance in the series of games where you're given the option to commit genocide. Essentially, completely wiping... Oh, what's happening here?
Serves as our voice. We cannot sing. Not in these low spaces. Your musics are colorless.
Musics? What?
Your way of communicating is strange, flat. It does not color the air. When we speak, one moves all. We are the mother. We sing for those left behind. The children you thought silenced. We are Rachni.
Okay, Shepard's a little dense on that.
How are you speaking through her?
Our kind sing through touchings of thought. We pluck the strings, and the other understands. She is weak to urging. She has colors we have no names for. But she is ending. Her music is bittersweet. It is beautiful. The children we birthed were stolen from us before they could learn to sing.
Now I feel bad about killing all the Rachni on my way here.
End their suffering. They cannot be saved. They will only cause
okay.
harm.
Never mind. They're just dumb insects at this point.
I don't understand. Why are your children killing people?
Weird. Needle men. I was missing somebody.
They stole our eggs from us. They sought to turn our children into beasts of war, claws with no songs of their own. Our elders are comfortable with silence. Children know only fear if no one sings to them. Fear has shattered their minds.
I understand. A child left alone in a closet until she is 16 would not be sane.
If you're sure they can't be saved.
It is lamentable, but necessary. Do what you must. Before you deal with our children, we stand before you. What will you sing? Will you release us? Are we to fade away once more?
The Rachni were a threat to the galaxy. Those tanks are filled with acid. If she gets out of hand, they dissolve her.
They made a mistake. They let the Krogan go too far. This is a chance for us to atone. She has done nothing to us.
Your companions hear the truth. You have the power to free us. Or return our people to the silence of memory.
Let's just,
they
should say.
If I let you live, would you attack other races again?
No, I
do not know what happened in the war. We only heard discordance, songs the color of oily shadows.
Reapers.
We would seek a hidden place to teach our children harmony.
Where are the Protheans?
Understand. Perhaps we would return.
Are you a survivor from the war? A clone?
We do not know. We were only an egg, hearing Mother cry in our dreams. A tone from space hushed one voice after another. It forced the singers to resonate with its own sour yellow note. Then we awoke in this place, the last echo of those who came out from the singing planet. The sky is silent.
I won't destroy your entire race. You'll go free.
You will give us the chance to compose anew?
Mm-hmm.
We will remember.
It takes two games, but this moment here does come up again in Mass Effect 3. Yeah.
I do not like this place. Too many darks.
Oh wow, I have a whole lot of levels to work on here. Let's get this up a bit. Transfer state. Fitness. Use that a lot. Here we are. You picked up advanced barrier. Nice. Okay, Garrus. Assassination. Next sniper. Still not working on this tactical armor, are you? Okay. Well, you have to somehow train to become a sniper, which you show up in Mass Effect 2 with. Okay, save. Let's see if we can get here. There we go. I didn't get much. I got Medigel. Got a grenade. That's good. Replace my grenade I used. Okay, so. Elevator in restricted areas. That's the tram. Where am I? Oh. Okay. I guess. Deal with the hot labs. Okay. So down in the hot lab. Okay, so I guess I need to go take that thing to the restaurant. Go this way. Go this way, yes. Let us go on a bug hunt. Okay, not that way. Here? Where am I going? Ooh, what's down here? Oh, did you really? Oh, okay. Okay, Liara, we get the point. You're cold. I screwed up that last one, didn't I? Oh, really? Come on. I'd at least get some of my, let me go back. Actually, I got 12. I think I got about halfway. How do I get out of here? do I need to go this way? Do I need to go? I can't go out this door. Okay, I get what I need. I need to go back to the trams and then up to the hot labs. Down to the hot labs. All the doors. Okay. Back here. There we go. Now it's green. Now we go into the elevator over here. Another elevator. Ding. Okay. Go on a bug hunt. Wait, okay. Oh. You're the dude who was on the,
Are you here to secure the situation?
How are you holding up?
You must listen to me. If we do not contain our mistake, they will drop bombs from the battle stations. You understand?
You let these things out?
I am only following the orders. Binary Helix found an egg. It was on a derelict ship, thousands of years drifting.
This story.
This was Ragnar's ship. Inside they find many eggs in cryogenic suspension.
A thousand-year-old egg hatched?
I don't get this.
It's very tough to be so long frozen. That it survived the centuries, this is miraculous.
I already got all this story. I got all this story from the Ragnar Queen itself, Amphinesia.
Mass produce them, create an army. But when they get here, they find this egg is not a common Ragnar. It is a queen. After she lays eggs, they move her to Rift Station. They are thinking that without her, they can raise the babies to be obedient.
Hold on. Don't you need a male to get eggs?
Queens are born carrying the genetic code of their fathers. Eggs are carried away from the colony to hatch alone. Queens can lay eggs in hours. And have a colony in days. This is how they spread so quickly.
Separating them from their mother didn't work.
This was exactly the wrong thing to do. I am thinking that without a queen, Ragnar do not develop properly. Her mind is shaping theirs. These Ragnar are uncontrollable.
Then all we need to do is bring her here.
No. I am sorry, but
I kind of feel like I should have gone here before the other thing.
These Ragnar are beyond saving. It is a sad thing, but they must be euthanized.
One area where Bioware kind of fell down on their narrative scripting.
Front purge must be set off.
I'm not familiar with the purge system.
It creates bursts of neutron radiation, kills everything within the station. Things beyond get genetic damage of varying degree.
Once the purge is armed, we'll have to fight our way out. Give us a minute to patch up and rearm.
Sure, sure. I wait here. I am not so much good for searching now, yes? Mother always say I would meet a bad end.
Okay.
I am feeling not so well.
How do we set off the purge?
Arming controls are nearby. All you do is insert the key. Then I will give Mira the struck.
Okay. Polygons. Not happy. Okay. Hot labs. I just need to go into here. Okay.
Okay. Connecting. I have full
access to the facility and am at your disposal.
What's the status of the facility?
I need to be asking this.
Breach in laboratory pod gamma. The neutron purge system is functional, but has not been armed.
Are there any survivors in here?
Lady Benezia, an executive secretary of Binary Helix, is on
and,
the operations.
Yeah, I really kind of screwed up the order of this,
there
didn't I?
There are no other living crew members within the lab structure.
How many Rachni are in here?
I'm sorry, the sensor network is too damaged to provide an accurate count.
Estimate.
Your best guess?
Guessing is beyond my design parameters, Commander.
Activate the neutron purge.
I'm sorry, but I can't do that without proper code authorization.
Mumble something.
Who would have the code?
Director of Operations, Yaroslav Tartakovsky.
Okay.
We're moving on.
Logging you out, Commander.
Journal. Seriously? Okay. I just know that there's gonna be more coming out. Break at this. Okay. Okay, I have to go give the order again. Yara, why did you stay in there? You got stuck.
Online, how can I help you?
Activate the neutron purge.
I'm sorry, but I can't do that without proper code authorization.
Code input 875020079. Code Omega local execution.
Verified. Code Omega
minutes.
Execution in 120 seconds.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Yeah, we're gonna wait till I can heal again. Run? Nope, wrong button. There we go. Run. Elevator. Boom. Well, we have neutron purged. Where am I? Okay. Mission complete. Okay. Do I not get to go talk to the people? Oh, you can't let me back in that way. Okay. There's nothing else here. That's my chances. You know, it's that horror movie thing. You get everything safe, you get onto the tram, you get halfway down the line, and all of a sudden there's a Rachni on board. Watch where we go. Whee! Train! And goes behind us. Okay,
what's our next move, Commander? Head for the Mu Relay?
The Mu relay could link to dozens of systems. Unless we know exactly where Saren's going, we'd just be wasting our time.
The commander is right. We cannot rush off blind. We still need to learn more about Saren.
Who put you in charge? Did the commander resign when I wasn't looking?
Oh, Shepard doesn't look very happy here.
We're all on the same team here, Williams. She's just trying to help.
Sorry, Commander.
Look, this is a tough mission. We're all on edge. Everyone go get some rest. Crew dismissed.
Noveria report is away, Commander. You want me to patch you through to the Council?
Yeah, I might as well.
Setting up the link now, Commander.
Is this report accurate, Commander? You found Rachni on Noveria?
I'm gonna be happy.
The Queen. Do you have any idea what you've done?
They're not happy with me.
They overrun the galaxy.
This queen is different. She understands why her kind had to be wiped out last time around.
I hope you're right, Shepard. Our children's children will pay the price if you're not.
We'll be waiting for your next report, Commander.
Okay. That was easy. Yep, saving. Paragon, plus two. Yay. Okay, you... What's there? They're doing pretty well on the pair. Pretty much renegade. Fine with that. Okay, so now, we have a big mission. You want to buy our game? You go talk to everybody. We're up here. We're up Joker. That there's careful because it's very easy to get stuck.
Boy, am I glad to be off of Noveria. I don't know which was worse, the cold or the corporations. One will freeze your balls off, the other will sell them out from under you. With all due respect, Commander.
How's the Normandy performing? Is she everything they said she'd be?
She's the best ship in the fleet. If you've got balances in one, okay. It's probably too much.
Not have anything.
I have to go.
Alright. I look forward to Mass Effect 2 when it's him and Edie talking. Okay. Let's go downstairs. Let us start. Go talk. Mummy just died. Yay! Items. Take all. Forgot what I need to sell here. That might be the beginning of like my next session. I'm just equipping everybody in.
If you are here to talk about Benezia's death, you need not bother. She brought it upon herself.
Don't pretend it doesn't bother you. She was your mother.
She was. But she was not. I prefer to remember Benezia as she used to be, before she was corrupted by Sovereign's power.
The best of your mother lives on in you. Her determination, her intelligence, her strength.
Barely knew her. You barely know Liara.
It's kind of you to say. I appreciate your concern, but I am fine. Benezia chose her path, just as I have chosen mine. I am with you until the end, Shepard.
Maybe we could pick up where we left off. You were telling me about your interest in the Protheans.
Actually, I think I was talking about my interest in you, and making a fool of myself in the process. As I said, I am not used to dealing with people, especially humans. I did not really know much about your species when we first met, Shepard. I found it hard to take humanity seriously. Your kind always seemed so rushed and high-strung.
We don't have the luxury of time. An Asari can live for 1,000 years. We're lucky if we hit 150.
That is true. At first I thought that was a weakness of your species. After spending time with you and your crew, however, I think it may actually be an advantage. You humans are creatures of action. You pursue your goals with an almost indomitable determination. It is an admirable trait, but also an intimidating one.
You're scared of us?
Unfortunately, the rest of the galaxy sees humanity as...
Yeah, we moved up pretty quickly.
...for anyone in your path to get what you want.
Relatively speaking.
...people like you to change their minds, Shepard.
I'm doing the best I can, Liara.
There is a reason the Council chose you to become a Spectre. They saw something special in you.
Yeah, she's a badass.
The best of what humanity has to offer. I looked into your history. I know what you did during the Blitz. It was a remarkable display of courage and heroism.
You didn't need to go behind my back. I would have told you whatever you wanted to know.
I apologize, Commander. After our last conversation, I was afraid I would say something stupid again. I wanted to know more about you. To understand what made you into the woman you are.
I think Liara has a little crush.
Compelling about you, Shepard.
Are you sure you're interested in me? Or is it my visions of Protheans?
I admit.
That was what I chose, was it?
Protheans had something to do with my initial interest. But it has grown beyond that. You intrigue me, Shepard. But I was not sure if it was appropriate to act on my feelings. I thought there might already be a relationship between you and Lieutenant Alenko.
No.
The Lieutenant and I are just friends. Nothing more.
My mistake, then. I am not as adept at understanding human relationships as I thought. But what about us, Shepard? Is there a mutual attraction, or was I wrong about that, too?
I think, yeah, we're gonna go with Liara. We're gonna go with Liara here, and in Mass Effect 3. Mass Effect 2, not there. I am going to get the DLC where we do get to see her, and she becomes... So I'm not gonna do that spoiler.
No, you are right. There is something between us.
I knew it, and I knew you felt it, too. But does this not seem rather strange? Why do I feel so close to you? We have only known each other a short time. We are from two different species. We have almost nothing in common. This makes no sense.
These things never make sense. They just happen and we get swept up in the storm.
You make it sound so chaotic, so dangerous.
I'll keep you safe.
I'm not looking for a protector. This is all a bit overwhelming. I am not used to this. You. I need some time.
Take all the time you need, Liara. I'll be here.
Thank you, Shepard. Let's just talk about something else for now.
Do you know why Benezia joined up with Saren?
Benezia was swept up in events beyond her control and lost herself. She fell under the spell of indoctrination and became part of the very thing she wanted to stop. But I will remember and honor how she lived, not how she died. My mother was strong, kind, and beautiful. And now she is gone.
Are you going to be okay?
You are kind to ask, Shepard. I do miss her, and I grieve for what happened to her. But I will not let my grief interfere with what we are trying to accomplish.
Sorry.
We were the first species to discover the Citadel. We were instrumental in forming the Council, and we always strive to be the voice of peaceful cooperation in galactic disputes. My people believe we are all part of a single galactic community. Each species contributes something to the greater whole. Although we seek to understand other species, it seems few of them seek to understand us. The galaxy is filled with rumors and misinformation about my people.
Like what?
Most of the inaccuracies are centered around our mating rituals. My species is monogendered, male and female.
Speak with really wide open eyes.
We still require a partner to reproduce. This second parent, however, may be of any species and any gender.
I don't understand. Your species can mate with anyone?
Mating is not quite the proper term, not as you understand. Physical contact may or may not be involved. But it is not an essential element of the union. The true connection is mental. Our physiology allows us to meld with other beings. We can touch the very depths of their minds. We explore the genetic memory of their species. We share the most basic elements.
I think I had to talk about this in my last discussion with her.
We then pass these traits on to our daughters.
I'm sorry if this is repeating information.
And how we develop a greater understanding of other races. Goodbye, Shepard.
Yes, Commander? Is there something you need?
I should go.
Goodbye, Commander.
She's much more fun in the other games. There I am. I think I'm to the table in front. Making him my quarters. Actually, become Miranda's quarters in this game. I get the cool quarters up on the top of the SR2. The Cadence, the Garrus of Mass Effect 1. He's always sitting there doing calibrations.
Sir, Lieutenant. I'm always open to my officers.
We've played it pretty close to the book so far, but we're a long way from backup. We've got some tough calls to make. I'm just saying, try to leave yourself a way out. I've seen what cutting corners can do, and I'd hate to have that happen to you, Shepard.
Where is it, my cut?
That's not the appropriate way to address your commanding officer, Lieutenant.
Sorry, ma'am. Maybe I got a bad signal. And if you're a... Maybe there's someone else you'd rather confide in. Ma'am.
Someone? You're referring to our young Prothean expert.
I think she's older than both of us put together, but, yeah. There's a lower deck room...
Caden's the Alistair. Alistair is the Caden of Dragon Age.
She's a very interesting lady, not to my tastes, but I don't.
Oh, you don't like the blue skin?
You seem awfully worried about my personal affairs.
It's just that we don't have much downtime these days. I like being around you, but I don't want to take up your personal time.
Look, there's nothing between Liara and me. What's the real issue here, Caden?
Something.
Sorry, it wasn't, Liara's not my main...
I need to shut him down.
I'm not questioning any decision you've made, Shepard. Let me be clear about that. It's just my experience that once someone lets something slide, it tends to pick up speed. You get my meaning?
Alenko, if you have one failure, it's an inability to speak directly.
Sorry, I'm not looking to dump any baggage, Shepard. You know the records about the biotic training out on Jump Zero? They're all classified, because the Alliance made mistakes. After first contact, Kinetix was set up to track Element Zero exposures and develop implants for humans. Once we had an embassy on the Citadel, Kinetix could bring in experts instead of taking it slow.
The only experts would have to be aliens.
Dead on. Turians, actually. That's why Kinetix kept it a secret. They were afraid of what people back home would think, asking the Turians for help when we just fought a war with them.
The Asari would have been more acceptable than the Turians.
Yes, but the company didn't go through the Citadel. It would have made Earth look weak, so they discreetly hired some Turian mercenaries.
Get your knuckles wrapped a few times, Lieutenant?
Yeah, you could say that. Our instructor was a Turian by the name of Commander Vernus. To introduce himself, he liked to say, I was at the helm of the dreadnought that killed your father. When I told him my dad wasn't in the war, he'd retired to Vancouver. My family had an inland home that matured to new beachfront.
Well, warming.
Vernus had it in for me after that. He cut corners, pushed hard. I mean, you either came out a Superman or a wreck. A lot of kids snapped. A few died. The point of all this, I guess, is that when you cut corners, it's not always obvious who pays for it.
Am I supposed to talk you down now or something? Because I'm not so good at therapy.
I'm 32, Shepard. You don't serve as long as I have without coming to terms with yourself. You also learn that if someone is special to you, you help them. Try to keep them from making mistakes.
So you think you have leave to talk like we're more than officers?
I got some signals. Maybe some static, too. Just say the word.
Sorry, Caden. This was just a battlefield thing.
There's my answer, then. I'm sorry to have bothered you, Commander. I got some mixed signals. With your permission, I should return to my duties.
Okay, yeah, we shut that down. Okay. Beam down. Another elevator. Ding. Eris. Calibrations of Mako.
Commander, good to see you.
You've been with CSEC a while. Have you seen much action?
Well, not as much as you, but yeah, I've seen some interesting things.
I bet you have. Anything in particular that stands out?
I remember this Solarian geneticist I was sent to investigate. That case was a bit disturbing.
What happened? Why were you investigating him?
I was tasked with tracking black market trade on the Citadel. Most of it harmless, nothing I needed to pursue. But during the course of my investigation, I noticed an increase in the trade of body parts, organs mostly.
Yum.
I had a few of those, but not the numbers I was seeing. We weren't sure if there was a new black market lab or if some freak was harvesting organs from citizens.
You've seen this before on the Citadel?
Every so often, some lab sells unwanted parts through the black market, but they're not as bad as the Psycho. I remember this one Elcor diplomat we caught in my first year on the job. He was hacking people up and selling their organs. Had the station in a bit of a panic. But this case wasn't that clear-cut. Turns out there was more going on than we first realized.
So how did you figure out what was happening?
First, we got a hold of a sample and ran DNA tests. The weird thing was, the match led us to a Turian who was still alive and was very convinced he'd never lost his life. After a bit of digging, I discovered this Turian briefly for Dr. Salion, the geneticist. So I went to his lab, hoping to find evidence of cloned organ development. But there was nothing. No Salarian hearts, no Turian livers, not one...
Krogan testicles?
You're kidding, right? Why would anyone want Krogan testicles?
Some Krogan believe that testicle transplants can increase their virility, counteract the effects of the genophage. It doesn't work, but that doesn't stop them from buying. They'll pay up to 10,000 credits each. That's 40,000 for a full set. Somebody's making a killing out there.
What'd you do about the geneticist?
I brought in some of his employees for interrogation to see if I could get them to talk. While I was interviewing one of them, I came across something suspicious.
Interviewing?
You mean threatening? Was that really necessary?
Maybe, maybe not. Either way, it paid off. One of my
detectives
started bleeding during the interview. We offered to patch him up and he got frantic, freaked out. I ordered a full exam to find out what was going on. Our medics found incisions all over his body, some of them fresh. That was our big break. These people weren't just Dr. Salion's employees. They were test tubes, walking, living test tubes.
He was growing parts inside these people?
Exactly. He cloned their organs right inside their own bodies.
So I watched the new show that Netflix had, Travelers. Deals with time travelers and everything. And they actually had a sequence where they did this here. They grew someone's, like, I think a liver replacement in another person. It was pretty nasty.
But only on the inside, hidden so nobody could see it.
I hope he got what he deserved.
That's the worst part. We never caught him.
Why not? What the hell happened?
He ran, blew his lab, grabbed some of his employees, and headed for the nearest space dock. By the time I found out, his ship was already leaving. He threatened to kill his hostages if we tried to stop him.
But you went after him anyway, right?
I ordered Citadel Defense to shoot him down, but CSEC headquarters countermanded my order. They were worried about the hostages, worried about civilian casualties if the ship was destroyed so close to the Citadel. I told them those hostages were dead anyway. He just used them to make more organs. But they wouldn't listen.
It's not worth the risk. You pursue the vessel and disable it. That's the best choice.
They sent the military after him, but he got away just the same. Yes, they did. I went to Palin and told him what I thought of him and his policies. He said if I didn't like it, I could quit. Well, I almost did. All they had to do was disable that ship, stop him from running. Maybe the hostages die, maybe they don't, but at least we stopped the bastard responsible for it all.
I suppose I can see both sides. But what's done is done.
I suppose. Can't waste too much time worrying about it now. Just wish I could have stopped him. That's all.
Do you have any idea what happened to Dr. Salian?
I sent out feelers from time to time, hoping to find something. I thought I'd found him a while back. He changed ships and changed his name to Dr. Hart, his idea of a joke, I guess. I told the military, but they weren't convinced it was him. I got the transponder frequency for his new ship, but I just can't get anyone to check it out.
Well, you are on an independent ship operating right now with a great degree of authority and jurisdiction.
I'll check out the coordinates when I get a chance.
I was hoping you'd say that, but Commander, take me with you when you go. If it's Salian, I want to be there when you find him.
Of course I'll take you with you. You're in all my parties. Rex!
What do you want, Shepard?
Like standing over your corner over here.
Why did you become a mercenary?
Lots of reasons.
Such as?
Such as, I needed to get out of our system. I needed to eat. I needed to survive.
Why not stay and help your people?
I tried to help. That's why I had to leave.
What happened?
I was betrayed. I was head of a small tribe. We were trying to restore order after the war, but the other tribes were against us. They followed Jared, one of the few warlords who survived the war with the Turians. But he was old, and so were his ideas. He wanted to continue the war. He wanted us to fight. Turians, Salarians, each other. It didn't matter who, as long as we were fighting.
Yes.
What do you want?
I just wanted Jared to shut up. To stop his ranting. I wanted him to stop leading the tribes astray.
Hey.
But he couldn't understand how much things had changed. We didn't have the numbers to go to war. Even if we did, the genophage made sure we...
That's all that they knew was war. They were uplifted for war.
All to forget about war. We needed to focus on breeding. At least for one generation. And for a while, we were getting through. Some of the tribes started coming around.
What about Jared?
I take it the warlord didn't appreciate that.
No, he didn't. He arranged a crush with the tribes. A meeting on neutral ground. He wanted...
Seen this before. Not in this game, but this plot, this narrative concept.
Our ancestors. The skulls of our dead laid bare to remind us where we come from. Where we all go. It's as sacred as any Krogan place can be. Violence is forbidden.
Sounds like a trap to me. You must have suspected as much.
It's a trap.
But when your father invites you to a crush, well,
father,
laws that even we hold sacred.
And we add in another possibility for patricide in this game.
Jared was your father?
He was.
Matricide, the matricide, it's insane, the genocide.
But we didn't get anywhere.
It's some tough choices
when
in this game.
That I wouldn't join him, he gave the signal. His men leapt from the graves of our ancestors like Krogan undead. The few that were loyal to me died quickly. I escaped with my life, but not before I sank my dagger deep into my father's chest.
Hey, never mind. He already did the...
...is why I left.
...patricide.
And that's why I'll never go back.
So long, Rex.
Shepard.
Ashley?
Commander?
Howard.
What's your opinion of the last mission?
You mean the Rachni, right? They were dangerous, Commander.
Yes, but you're a xenophobe.
But that wasn't my call to make. It was yours. You know, you really should talk to Tassoni about her mom. She has to be heard.
Been there, done that.
Just saying, Commander.
Can we talk?
Do you have a few minutes to talk? One-on-one?
Sure. I was just watching some mail from home.
Oh, before I go, we saw Caden in a news vid about the Normandy. He's cute. Later, sis.
Let's pretend this never happened.
Are you interested in the lieutenant, Chief?
Fraternization is against regulations, ma'am. Don't ask, don't tell. What's up? You didn't come by to eavesdrop on family mail.
I have a trip.
Your family seems to be important to you.
Yeah, we've always been close. Me and my sisters especially. With Dad on duty so much, I had to help Mom raise them.
Okay.
Did your father serve with the fleet?
Yeah, took any crap posting he could get that offered space time. He worked his ass off trying to get recognized, but he never made it above serviceman third class.
He's probably not a badass, like Shepard is.
First thing he did was salute.
What about your mother? You haven't mentioned her.
You must know what military wives are like. Strong because they have to be, able to raise kids while Dad's away on a 6-month cruise. She has a degree in planetary geology. She and Dad both wanted to see new worlds. She gave up her career to raise us, though.
More than one sister? Sounds like a big family.
Yeah, I'm the oldest, then Abby, then Lynn. Sarah's the youngest. She's still in high school. With four girls, Dad used to say he felt more outnumbered at home than on maneuvers.
Where did you grow up?
All over. Same as you, I expect. We transferred a half a dozen times before I finished grade school. You go where personnel command sends you, right? I guess that's why I'm so tight with my sisters. We'd have to leave all our friends every 2 or 3 years.
Sounds.
I was an only child, but I get the idea. At least one of my parents was always on duty.
Yeah, military families, eh? With schedules like that, it's a wonder we ever have kids anymore. Things were tense between Sarah and me for a while. Then we bonded.
Sounds like a story. Feel like sharing?
Sarah got herself a boyfriend who wanted to go faster than she did. Mike.
Interesting, because in Mass Effect 2, Miranda deals with a sister relationship.
I'd tell her to relax.
Where were you when this was going on?
I was on active duty. Sarah's graduating high school this year. This was only a couple of years back. They were on Amaterasu. At the time, I was assigned to Chernobyl. Same cluster, but a dozen Hellwai away.
Light years, for those not
too far to make it back in an emergency. I couldn't afford a fast packet flight.
No means no.
Liked her, he wouldn't be pushy.
Yeah, of course. If he didn't ask at all, I'd wonder if he thought Sarah was ugly. Damned if you do, damned if you don't. Mike thought they'd go for a romantic walk in the woods, because he figured it was past time they did the deed. She levered Mike face first into a tree and left.
Good for her.
Good thing Mom and Dad had us all learn some kind of self-defense. I took emergency leave and walked Sarah to school for a few days.
Why didn't you tell the police?
She said it wouldn't solve the real problem, and she and Mike would both become household names. It was a small colony. I said it was her call to make, that we should let her do it her way. Mom was pretty pissed about that.
Hold on a second. Oops. Sorry about that. They're buzzing. Okay. Okay. But, continue.
You said all of your sisters learned self-defense?
Lynn did pistol practice, but didn't like it. She's kind of nervous. Sarah took Aikido. Abby decided to learn the sword. She always was a little weird. Likes big skirts and tops you have to tie her into. They do great things to her figure, though.
So, what did you learn?
One of Dad's friends taught me Marine hand-to-hand.
You said all of your sisters learned.
I think it just is.
Blended.
Okay.
They do great things to her figure.
Dedicated.
You traveled all the way home to walk your sister to school.
It was only a dozen light years, like a day's cruise. It's not like it was going to Earth or something. My last day out, Mike was waiting for us. Sarah had told her friends, so everyone at school knew what he did. He wasn't happy. I wanted to snap him in half,
but Sarah gave me this look. This, let me handle it, I need to do this alone look. She kept her cool, God bless her, as he screamed in her face. She just let him vent. Then he tried to punch her. I swear, she just flowed around him. Next thing I knew, he's face down on the sidewalk, and there's blood everywhere.
That's unbelievable. Sarah must be as good as you.
Better. I'm more or less a straight-up puncher. When he swung, she just... she wasn't there anymore, and he fell.
Big spike. Cowboy Bebop.
She stopped the bleeding and had me call an ambulance. She told the paramedics he fell. Before they took him to the hospital, Mike touched Sarah's arm. I thought he was going to end up on the ground again. But he hung his head, whispered, I'm sorry, and started crying. And she hugged him. The Williams women are a decisive bunch, Commander. We do things when we're ready. Not before, not after.
Your sister's something else. But you didn't mention your father at all. Was he on deployment?
Dad always wanted to serve in space. But he wanted us to have real ground under our feet. He'd say, space is beautiful, but you can't raise a family there. I cannot rest from travel. I will drink life to the lees. All times I've enjoyed greatly have suffered greatly, both with those that loved me and alone.
We get poetry.
For always roaming with a hungry heart, much have I seen and known. Cities of men and manners, climates, councils, governments.
I never thought I'd hear you reciting poetry.
Just because I can drill you between the eyes at 100 meters doesn't mean I can't like sensitive stuff. Just don't spread it around.
Whoa.
Ulysses was my dad's favorite poem. Every time he shipped out, he recorded me reading it. He had a dozen versions when he retired.
Does he still like it?
I sure hope so. I read it to his grave every time I go home.
Fresh.
Dad passed on a few years back. He's probably still watching, though.
You mean from wherever we go after death?
Dead on, Skipper. He's with God now.
A real religious sort.
That's not a problem with you, is it? That I believe in God?
Of course.
Everyone has the right to believe what they want. Says so in the Alliance Charter. Only with fancier words.
Mm-hmm.
I'm glad you're open-minded about it.
Yeah, as long as you're not trying to convert me, that's fine.
Space, I can't believe in a higher power. Jeez. Hello, have you people looked out the window? How can you look at this galaxy and not believe in something? I should get back to my duties. Didn't mean to take up so much of your time.
Dismissed, Chief.
Ma'am.
Okay. Let's go talk to Tally. And I think I'm going to call it a night. Week we'll go... actually, I'm not going to be playing next week. I'm going to be at a conference next week. So, it'll be 2 weeks. So in 2 weeks, read a thing, get a level. In 2 weeks, I will probably do some assignments, head back to the Citadel, equip everybody with all the stuff and resell stuff, get a bunch of cash. And then I will, then we have to go on to Pharos, deal with the Geth.
I know Theron's our top priority, but with all the worlds we go to, I was hoping to find something to bring back to the flotilla.
We've still got a long way to go. You'll find something to take back.
Yes, but it cannot just be some derelict ship my people can use for salvage. It has to be more than that. There's a lot expected of me.
What's so special about you?
It's my father.
Tally.
He's the senior member of the Admiralty Board. He's one of only 5 people who can overrule the decisions of the Conclave for the good of the Migrant Fleet. My father is responsible for the lives of 17 million people.
This is a big deal. Only child. I think Mass Effect 2, Mass Effect 3, I don't remember which one actually, that we deal with Tally's father. And there's like a whole trial thing. Your royalty?
So are you some kind of heir to the Quarian throne or something?
Yeah, a Quarian princess.
Serve on the Admiralty Board myself. Officially, I'm just the same as any other citizen, but it doesn't work that way in practice. People have always treated me differently because of who my father is.
You must get all kinds of special privileges.
I probably had it easier than most growing up, But it's not all good. People like my father have enemies, and they're not above using me to get to him.
Must be tough on you.
My people place a high value on family and ancestry. There's an unspoken expectation that I'll live up to my father's example. Everyone's waiting for me to do something great on my pilgrimage. Something that will forever change our lives for the better. If I don't, it's like I failed. And that
I love the Corian armor. I just love the whole design, the textures that are on there, and they just look better in the later games when we get to higher resolution textures. If we save the galaxy.
But you have to understand Quarian culture. We're a very insular society. The events beyond the flotilla don't much matter to the average citizen. Our greatest dream is that one day we'll return to our homeworld and drive out the Geth. But even if we stop Saren, that's not going to happen. There's still millions of Geth behind the veil. Until they're gone, our exile will continue.
What would you need to bring back to make everyone happy?
Something that would help us better understand the Geth. They've changed significantly since the exile. They've continued to evolve. We've done our best to study them, but it's not easy. They're very reclusive. Until recently, they never went beyond the
borders. Oh, so you're gonna like being on Pharos.
The Geth we run into now are under Saren's control. We'd need to find Geth operating on their own, independently. But I don't want this to get in the way of our mission, Shepard. First, we stop Saren. Then I'll worry about my own problems.
Okay, we've done everything there.
I should go.
And so I think I'm gonna save here. Actually, level up before I forget. Okay. Fitness is. I like not dying. Okay, so with this, I am going to save, and I'm going to call it a night. Thank you for anybody who joined me, and this will again be archived up on YouTube. Next time I'll be playing is going to be Tuesday night, doing some independent game then. I don't know what I'm going to play yet. I'm going to figure it out before that night. Don't know if I'll be playing on the PC or the PlayStation. We'll see what I'm in the mood for to play that night. I will not be playing next Friday or next Sunday because I'll be at a library conference. The next time I'll be playing again will be the Tuesday, the 24th, after that. Again, another independent game. And then we should be back onto the regular schedule for a while. So thank you for coming. Thank you for watching, and that's it.